Hello, folks, and welcome. Here we are with WordPress 3.3 and the Ultimate Tiny MCE plugin. I have all of my buttons available here and want to just show a quick tutorial on how to use some of them. You don't have to have all of these enabled. I'll show you the settings page momentarily where it'll allow you to enable and disable each of the buttons. But I want to scroll through a couple of these real quick. The first thing I want to show is YouTube. We can see we have a simple pop-up and we can just put in the link format. So if we pull up YouTube here, let's go to YouTube, and I'm just gonna, since I'm already logged in, grab one of my videos. And forgive me for moving fast, I just want to squeeze in as much as I can here. We're going to click the share button, and all we have to do is take this short code, copy, and come back over to our editor here and just paste it right into the link sharing and insert. And that will insert a preview box here, and this is safe. If we switch over to our HTML, we can see the code being used to insert it. But we can also switch back and it's safe, which has been a problem before. Now if we preview this, you'll see that it opens up and there's the video, and of course we can play it and we're good to go. So let me X out of that. We're going to take this out, and the button beside this is insert embed media. What this is good for is like Google Maps. If we go in here and go to Google Maps, and I'm just going to zoom in on my part of the world here, down Kentucky Way, and up here. Okay, I'm just going to take this part by the river. I live about 10 minutes from the river here. Okay, that's good. So we're going to take this, and we are going to take the embed option, which is an iframe. We're going to copy that. Come back over to our page. And in the source tab of, again, this is the insert embed media. Over in the source tab, we can just paste this in here, switch back, and you can see that it's got our map here by the river. And all we have to do is insert. Again, we can swap back and forth and see that it's safe between switching. Let's preview. Scroll down, and then there's Google Map, which works just as it should. Okay. So let's take this out of here. Okay, another one I want to show is, let me insert an image. I'm just going to take one out of here that I've got already. I'm going to take this link out of here and insert. Okay, so if we have an image in our post, let's highlight it, and this feature here, Image Map Editor. Okay, this will let us create different shapes to make image maps on. So we can make a square here, and we can make this one a circle and put that there, and then we don't need the last one. So we're going to make this link to my form, and we're going to make this one link to my portfolio. And we're going to make each one of them open up in a new page. And we'll select new window. Alright, so we've got our square and our circle image maps, well, rectangle actually, so we're going to update. And we can switch back and forth. You can see the code here for Summoning Image Map. Let's come back over. We're still safe. Let's preview this. And if you watch, as we come over, my mouse gets over that square. You can see I'm changing to a link. And if you look in the bottom left of my browser, you can see forum.joshloeb.com. So if we click that, there's my forum in a new window. So if we come off of that square, you can see my mouse changes. We get to that circle, and you can see that's my portfolio link. And that indeed opens in a new window as well. So that's what image mapping is. And this one's a circle, so as you move over it, you can kind of see. And then this one's the square. All right. Let's look at, let me undo this. And let's look at our, I have an HTML button that lets you view the source, but the only thing I don't like about it is it doesn't separate it very well. It just crams it all together. It takes out all of the white space, so it's kind of hard to look in there and see precisely where you need to be. This advanced HTML button, this one here, will break it down, and it actually color codes and uses syntax highlighting as well as line numbers. So that makes it a lot easier to work with for me. And instead of using the HTML editor and switching over here, I find myself most all the time popping open this window and working with it because it resembles Dreamweaver, which is what I use most all of the time. So that's a very cool feature. Most of the rest of them are just ones that have been on here. You can edit any CSS style for any elements like spans or paragraph tags. You can use anchors and page references to move through your content, subscripts, superscripts. Search and replace, you can insert little smiley moods that are animated into your post. There he is. Cut, copy, and paste is normal, horizontal rule. And let's see, preview. And this kind of lets us open up a preview window to see what it's like, and it'll show us how it's looking as we create it. All right, let's go to the settings page quickly. And here you can see, here's the row three buttons, and you can choose, select which ones you want to include in your editor. And down here is the same for row four. And then these three are a couple of advanced features that you can enable. And then here I've got a couple of kind of miscellaneous things I've been working on. You can use PHP text widgets, so you can run PHP code from one of your widgets. You can allow short codes in your widget. And this one is one of my favorites, custom message box to your register and login page. So you can write any HTML in here for your register and login page, and then when you go to it, pardon me, this little one, here we are. You can see here's my custom message. So I have a link that you can make somewhere. You can include a image, and you can even put a video down there. Just take the embed code from YouTube and include that in your settings box here, and you can have a video on your register and login page. So very cool options. I think the help messages, like if you want to see what this does, I put a help message with each one, and this will open up a little pop-up window, and we'll kind of explain how to use it. We'll show you a screenshot of the front or of helpful items. The sign-off short code has its own little help window that you can use, and I've put screenshots to kind of show you what it does and how it works. So each one of these options has its very own help window, which explains what it does. A couple of screenshots. If I've gotten that far with it, I'll be updating this as it goes. I've put stars on the ones that are new features. So this is the plugin, and there's a lot more to it. This is just a real quick overview, and there will be a lot more to come as well. And I have a very active support forum that I stay on, and I appreciate everyone taking the time to view this. So I hope you enjoy, and I hope to see you on the forums. Thank you.